हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस साइड मीना. सो वेलकम इन अ नेक्स्ट वीडियो. दिस इज़ द लास्ट वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द चैलेंजेस ऑफ अडोलेसेंस. अर्लियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन्फेंसी एज एंड द चाइल्डहुड एज. अडोलेसेंस इज द टर्म दैट इज ड्राइव फ्रॉम द लैटिन वर्ड. इट मीन्स टू ग्रो इन टू मेजोरिटी. अडोलेसेंस वी कॉमनली डिफाइंड एज द स्टेज ऑफ लाइफ. In this, the person gains sexual maturity and the person is having the ability to reproduce also. In this period, the changes are there both biologically and psychologically. Biological changes are universal in nature, but psychological and cultural changes that the adolescents experience, it depends on the culture in which the child is living. For example, the experiences of Indian culture child will be different from the experiences of the Western culture. Now we will discuss it in brief. Firstly, we will talk about the physical development. Physical development can be characterized in the adolescence by dramatic physical changes in both growth rate and sexual characteristics. In this, the hormones release. We can see this development in two sexual characteristics. First is at primary and second is the secondary. In the primary, sex characteristics directly related to the reproduction, and in the secondary sex characteristics, it include the signs of achieving the sexual maturity. Growth generally begins at the age of 12 or 13 year for the boys and the age of 10 or 11 for the girls. There can be variations in the sequence of the puberty. Like among two boys of the same chronological age, one may complete the pubertal sequence before the other has just begun. In the physical growth, both the genetics and environmental also play a very crucial role. Physical development during the adolescence also accompanied by so many psychological changes. In this, the person is attracted towards the opposite sex and the person also know about their changing feelings. Actually, sex is a topic that the parents also feel difficulty to discuss with the children. So, adolescents tend to become secretive about the sexual concerns, which may exchange of information and communication difficulties. The development of sexual identity defines sexual orientation and guides sexual behavior. Adolescents need to develop a realistic image of their physical appearance to which they are more acceptable. It is important to keep in the mind that puberty also involves cognitive and social changes along with the physical. So now we will discuss about the cognitive developmental changes in the adolescence. Under the cognitive development, the adolescence became more abstract, logical and idealistic. The theory given by Piaget, in his theory he said that in this age the child reach at the formal operational thought. This includes the children of age from 11 to 15. In this, child can understand the abstract terms and they can reason about anything. In this, the children also having idealistic standards to whom the child after that compare his own characteristics. Firstly, they try to develop the standard of the ideal parent by looking at someone. After that, they compare their parents with that ideal parent's standard. In the same way, when they look at the one person's personality in the idealistic manner, then they try to compare their own personality with that standards. In this, the child is also having a systematic problem-solving ability. They try to give different solutions to the problem that proceed a systematic solutions. This thing that develop in the child is known as a logical thinking. The Piaget called this type of logical thinking as a hypothetical deductive reasoning. If we talk about the another aspect of the adolescence, that is moral development, then we must remember that logical thought and the society also has impact on the morality of the child. As the child is having the moral thinking, this moral thinking is having the flexibility that is not stable and it can change with the passage of time. In this, firstly, the child observes the things that are around him. After that, he tried to make his own opinion. Like, the child asks the questions in the morality form to himself, that should I smoke as everyone I know does? Is it ethical to copy answers in the examination? So after, on the basis of this observation, child also develops some moral code for himself. Adolescence is also having one special kind that is known as the egocentrism. According to David Alkind, he gave two components of the adolescent's egocentrism. First one is the imaginary audience and second one is the personal fable. In the imaginary audience, the adolescents always have a belief that is preoccupied, that everyone around them is observing them and they are noticing their each and every type of behavior. We can take example, like if there is an ink spot on the shirt of a boy, then the child will always think that everyone is just paying their attention on that ink spot that is on his shirt. A girl with a pimple feels that all the people are looking at her skin and they are just comparing her skin with the another girl. So this is a imaginary audience. This makes the child very conscious about their self. The second part of is that the personal fable. It is a sense of uniqueness. In this, the child think that they have some type of uniqueness in them and nobody else can understand their feelings, that what they feel. You may have also experienced these things, or you can see that when the children always say that no one can understand them to their parents. Actually, the children who are in the adolescence age, they always live in a fantasy world and they are just away from the reality. Our next one is forming an identity. In this, we can take some examples, like when the child tries to ask himself or herself about his own identity, that who I am, what is my motives, which type of goals I want to achieve. If we talk about in the academics of the child, then the child will ask which subject should I study. So all these things, when child try to search about his self, it is known as a identity. We can also define identity in terms that identity is who you are and what your values, commitments and beliefs are. The primary task in the adolescence is the adolescence. It is a primary task to establish an identity that separate the child from their parents, because the child has his own identity now. In this, the child has their own personal set of beliefs that are very unique to him. In the process of the identity, child also experience some type of conflict with the parents or within himself or herself. When the child is able to cope up with this type of conflicts, then this give a new sense of self. Mean to say, if the child want to become a sports person, but on the other hand, the parents want to make the child a doctor, then there is a conflict between the parents and the child. So the child has to resolve that conflict. When child is able to resolve this conflict, what new experience. On the other hand, adolescents who are not able to cope with this type of identity, they suffer from the identity crisis. This is known as a identity confusion also. Erikson said that this lead to the isolating, mean to say the child tried to isolate himself from his peer groups and the family. He avoid to go in the crowd, in parties or the functions. Fluctuation in the emotions of the children. During this process, adolescents also influenced by several factors. It also include the background of the family, cultural background, what type of society, what type of values that is given to the child by the society and the family. During the adolescence, family relationship become less important to the child, as the child spend more his time in the company of his peer group. This also help in developing new social skills in the child behavior. There is sometimes conflict between the parents' thought and the peer thought, but generally parents and peers serve as a complementary functions. There is another factor, that is vocational commitment, that influences the adolescent's identity formation. As the name suggests, vocational, so it is related with the career options to the child. As we know that in some cultures, there is less freedom to the children to choose their career according to their choice, whereas culture are there which provide more options to the children according to their own choice. Mostly here, parents' decision is likely to be accepted by the children. In this, the children can take the help of career counseling in schools, which offer information regarding their course or the jobs that they want to pursue in the future. There are some major concerns also related to the adolescence. we are in the age of adolescence, then we know that there is a peer pressure and we like the company of our peer. Sometime the peer pressure is in a positive, in a negative way. Adolescents always confronted with the decisions regarding the smoking, drugs, alcohol. Adolescents may face some of the problems like loneliness, when they have doubt on their own identity, they feel anxiety, and they have so many concerns about their life also. So all these things include excitement also, joy also, and they feel anxiety also on some points. So we have some major challenges that the adolescents face. Let's discuss them in detail. First one under this is the delinquency. Delinquency actually refers to that type of behavior that are not acceptable from the society point of view. It includes some type of legal offenses, criminal acts, etc. In this, we can take the example like running away from the home when child is not able to confront the situations, or the child is not able to adjust in the family, stealing the things. Adolescents with delinquency or some type of behavioral problems always have negative self-identity. They don't have trust on their self. They have low level of achievement. So delinquency has a cause of occurring with low parental support, and it can be happened due to the inappropriate discipline in the family. The adolescents, those who come under this category, they came from the community which we can characterize by poverty, unemployment. However, most delinquent children do not remain delinquent forever. If we do change in their peer group, then they can become more aware about the social responsibilities, the feeling of their self-worth or respect by imitating the positive behavior or by providing the good role model. We can help them in improving their behavior. Our next one is the substance abuse. Substance abuse include the smoking, alcohol, and drug abuse. For the adolescent, start taking this type of abuse because they are not able to cope up with stress. They are not able to take their decisions. In this substance abuse, there is an addictive part of nicotine. To that, it is difficult to stop smoking. To overcome this type of behavior, there should be positive relationship with the parents, peers, siblings. In India, a successful anti-drug program is the Society for Theatre in Education program in New Delhi. It used street performance to entertain people between 13 to 25 years of age while teaching them how to say no to drugs. Our next one is the eating disorder. As we know that adolescents lives in a fantasy world and they are also having a peer group pressure. In this stage, they try to look at themselves and they are more concerned about their body shape also, about their physique also. So due to this, there are some eating disorders develop in the children at the age of adolescence. In this, the first one is anorexia nervosa. It is an eating disorder. In this, the child try to eliminate the food. He try to avoid the food and reach at the stage of starvation even. It happens due to the media effect also, when they try to copy the fashionable images of thinness. So it leads to the eating disorder. Our next one is the bulimia. It is another form of eating disorder. In this, the child try to purge the eating by vomiting, or the try used to take fast. So anorexia nervosa and bulimia are the primary female disorders that we can found commonly in the urban families. Our next stage is the adulthood and old age. After the adolescence, we reach at the age of adulthood. In this, the child become more responsible, mature, and self-supporting. It suggested that there is a shift in timing when an individual becomes an adult. The adult roles are always directed by the individual social context. So we will discuss about some important aspects of the adulthood life. Firstly, the career and the work. After the adolescence, the person is having a desire to earn his living. We enter in the work life, then there are so many challenges that everyone face in their life. There are some apprehensions regarding different adjustment. We have to show our performance. We have to deal with the competitions, and we have to fulfill the expectations also. So this is the new beginning of the roles and the responsibilities. After that, the phase come of the marriage, parenthood, and the family. In this, the adjustments that the young adults have to make when the individual enter in a marriage state. Individual has to cope with each other's likes, dislikes, taste, and choices. adjustment is needed there so that they can share and perform their roles and responsibilities home also or in the society also. In addition to getting married, there is another phase that comes in the individual life, that is the becoming a parent. This is very difficult stage and it is also have a responsibility. In this, the person accompanied by the feeling of love for the baby. Parenting experiences for the adult always affected by different situations, like how many children are in the family, what type of social support they are having, are they happy in their married life, or what type of income status they have. So the death of a spouse or any circumstances that cause divorce situation, so it create a panic in the family and in the family structure. Now this time we can see that both the partners are doing work outside the home and inside the home also. If the both the parents are working, it is also quite difficult for the parents to manage the thing outside also and at home also, which include taking care of children, their school work, illness, and coping with the workload. Despite all these stressors, this stage also provide a unique opportunity for growth and satisfaction. With the passage of time, there are also some physical changes and cognitive changes, like decline in vision, hearing loss, memory loss. So in the same manner, there is a decline in the memory also. Our next stage is old age. Earlier, the person is considered in the old age when the person retired from his work. But now, the people are living longer also. So the definition to the old age also changed. When the person is in the old age, the person has to face so many challenges, but still the image of the old age is changing in certain ways. Now these days people are very active, energetic and creative. We can see this type of people in the politics also, literature and art and science. The old age also, our life is depend or affected by the socioeconomic conditions, which type of healthcare facilities are there, what is the attitude of the people towards the person, and what is the status of the person in the society. A successful old age considered when the person is very good at work and person has good friendship or relationship in the family also and in the society also. When the person take retirement from the active vocational life, it is little bit significant to the person as it gave the satisfaction. Old age persons has to adjust in the new changes environment, as with the passage of time, family structure also change. They have to play new roles. They have to depend on their children for the financial support also. In old age, feeling of loss of energy and declining health issues and financial assets, it arose the feeling of insecurity. In most oriented cultures, rear their children so that their children will take care of them during their old age. It is important to give the elderly a sense of security and belonging. So if there is a death of a spouse, then it is very difficult to survive, as it arose the feeling of deep grief. People in different cultures view death differently. Like country, like in the Gond culture in our country, it is believed that death is caused by magic and demon. I hope that in this chapter, Human Development, you have read so many things that how our personality, how our development is changes with the passage of time. So this chapter help you to understand the influence of various factors in an individual's lifetime. This is all about this chapter. I hope that you have understood this chapter very well. Try to read it thoroughly by your own side also. Thank you.